Hi guys, guess what? I found another villa and it's pink. Maybe we can buy it. Maybe I can research the cost. It has, you know, darker reddish color at the bottom and pink on top, and it has lions and women and flowers. Yes. So what about this villa? We are at Drahomanova Street, and this is actually is not for sale. This is Lviv National Museum, and it was actually purchased by Metropolitan Andrei Sheptytsky. I will tell you about him in a second and about what's going on here. But right now I will tell you where we are. We are in the center, up the hill. There is Citadel. Is the fortification complex built by the Austrians, and all around me there are different departments of Ivan Franko University. And among this all beautiful architecture is this beautiful pearl. This is former Dunyakovsky Villa, the residence of geology professor Emil Dunyakovsky, who was a professor at Ivan Franko University. It was built between 1897 and 1898. It was built in late historicism style with elements of neo-baroque and late romanticism. Do you like this style? I like it. I think it's cute. There's a museum that exhibits modern art of many artists which are at the forefront of the early 20th century. You can see art, permanent art exhibition, and you definitely should visit this exhibition. So these are the names of painters: Ivan Trush, Oleksa Novakivsky, Olena Kulchitska. Why should you care about museums in Lviv? Because it's an amazing way to understand our culture and our tastes. In our art, from my observation, there's a lot of nature, a lot of huts, family life is depicted, women are depicted often, women in their traditional costumes. And so it depicts our love of hard work, our love of nature, how we work in fields, and of course flowers and food. This is why you should visit museum in Lviv to understand us better. So who is the owner of this building now? In 1911, Andrei Sheptytsky purchased real estate at Drahomanova 42. He reconstructed the buildings and moved the art collections and archives and library from St. George premises, the St. George Cathedral, do you know about it? The founder transferred his possessions to Ukrainian people in the 19th century. This event marked a new period in the cultural life of Western Ukraine. It was widely covered by European press. Between 1930 and 1935, new museum facility was constructed in functionalism style. This is where you should go to see all the exhibitions. The museum was restored and opened in 2013. Who is Andrei Sheptytsky? He was the Metropolitan Archbishop of the Ukrainian Greek Catholic Church between 1901 and 1944 until his death. His tenure spent 2 world wars and 7 political regimes: Austrian, Russian, Ukrainian, Polish, Soviet, Nazi, and Soviet regimes. He was a wealthy man, and he was able to make such purchase for us. Sheptytsky family is from an aristocratic Ruthenian line, which in the 19th century had become Polonized, Roman Catholic and French speaking. Sheptytsky received his education first at home and then in Krakow. After graduating, he went to serve in the Austro-Hungarian army, but after a few months fell sick and was forced to abandon it. Instead, he studied law in Krakow and Wroclaw, receiving his doctorate in 1888. Despite his father's opposition, Sheptytsky became a monk, and he returned to his roots to serve what was regarded as the peasant Ukrainian Greek Catholic Church. He also studied at the Jesuit seminary in Krakow, receiving a doctoral degree in theology in 1894. He visited North America in 1910, where he met with Ukrainian Greek Catholic immigrant communities in the United States. After the outbreak of World War I, Szeptycki was arrested by the Imperial Russian government and imprisoned. Bolsheviks destroyed his parents' rural house in Prilbychi, where he was born. During this time, a lot of family archives were lost. He also learned Hebrew to better relate to the Jewish community. And during World War II, he harbored hundreds of Jews in his residence and in Greek Catholic monasteries. Szeptycki died in 1944 and is buried in St. George Cathedral in Lviv. Jews who were saved thanks to actions of Andrei Szeptycki have lobbied Yad Vashem for years to have him named righteous among the nations. Thank you for watching this video. Please like it and subscribe to the channel. Bye. Thank you.